हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ठाकुर विद्या मंदिर हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट पार्ट टू ऑफ चैप्टर फोर बिजनेस सर्विसेज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ वन ऑफ द बिजनेस सर्विसेज नोन एज बैंकिंग। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन, मीनिंग, डेफिनेशन एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बैंक्स। इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ बैंकिंग। द टर्म बैंक कम्स फ्रॉम द फ्रेंच वर्ड बैंको विच मीन्स अ बेंच। इन अर्लियर डेज मनी लेंडर्स यूज टू डिस्प्ले कॉइन्स ऑफ डिफरेंट करेंसीज इन बिग हिप्स और बेंचेस और टेबल्स फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ लेंडिंग और एक्सचेंजिंग। मीनिंग ऑफ बैंकिंग। अ बैंक इज अ फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन विच डील्स विद डिपॉजिट्स एंड एडवांसेस एंड अदर रिलेटेड सर्विसेस। It means a bank is an institution which deals with deposits of money from the public, and bank give them advances in the form of loans to the public, as well as bank provides other related services. Bank provides various services related to money or financial requirements of customers, like they are giving the bank draft facilities, they are collecting and giving the salaries to their employees, they are collecting and giving the dividends, underwriting services. So bank provides various services to their customers. Now we are going to learn the definition of banking. As per the Indian Regulation Act 1949, banking company means any company which transacts the business of banking in India. And the word banking has been defined as excepting for the purpose of lending or investment of deposits of money from public, repayable on demand or otherwise, and withdrawable by check, draft and order or otherwise. It means bank is collecting the money from the public in the form of deposit and lending the money to the public, and whatever money they had collected in the form of deposit, maybe the saving account, maybe the current account, or in the form of fixed deposit account, that will be repayable on demand from the customers, or they can withdraw by check, draft, or through any other sources. Now we are going to learn what are the different types of banks. Different types of banks are सेंट्रल बैंक, कमर्शियल बैंक, कोऑपरेटिव बैंक, डेवलपमेंट बैंक, एक्सचेंज बैंक, रीजनल रूरल बैंक, सेविंग्स बैंक, इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंक, स्पेशलाइज्ड बैंक। वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न मीनिंग फंक्शंस ऑफ ईच टाइप्स ऑफ बैंक्स। Students, we are going to start first with the central bank. The central bank is the apex financial institution in the banking industry in the country. Every country has their own central bank. In India, the Reserve Bank of India is the central bank of India. The RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India, was established in 1945 under the Reserve Bank of India Act 1944. Functions of RBI. First, RBI frames monetary policies for the nation. Second, RBI issue currency notes. Third, RBI act as a banker to the government. Fourth point is RBI act as a banker's bank to the commercial and other banks in India. It means RBI is the head of all the commercial and the cooperative banks or any other industrial bank in India. Here you can see the images of RBI as well as the symbols of RBI. Second is commercial bank. Commercial bank plays an important role in economic and social development of a country. Commercial bank performs important functions such as primary and secondary function. So here we can see in the diagram function of commercial bank. It is divided into two parts, primary function and secondary function. What are the primary function? The primary function is accepting of deposit and lending of money. Accepting of deposit, it means they are collecting the money from the public in the form of savings account, current account, fixed deposit account, recurring deposit account, and lending of money in the form of loans and advances. Secondary function. Secondary function, it means it is also divided into two functions, that is the agency function and utility function. Agency function, it means they are collecting the dividend and making the payment to their customers, or they are doing the payment of the salary, fund transfer from one branch to the another branch. And utility function, they are issuing the draft and check, locker facilities, underwriting services, etc. In India, commercial banks are divided into three groups. So we are going to learn what are that three groups. First is the public sector banks. Public sector banks, where majority of the capitals held by government. Examples of such banks are Bank of India, State Bank of India, etc. Second is private sector bank. Private sector banks are owned by group of individual people. Example, Axis Bank, HDFC Bank, etc. Third is foreign bank. Foreign banks are those banks which are established outside India but have branches in India. For example, HSBC Bank, Citibank, Standard Chartered Bank, etc. Third is cooperative bank. In India, cooperative banks are registered under the Cooperative Societies Act and regulated under Banking Regulation Act. Cooperative banks are popular in semi-urban and rural areas. Main aim of cooperative bank is to provide credit to economically backward people, farmers and small scale unit. So their main aim is to give the funds who are economically poor people, farmers as well as to the small scale units. Cooperative banks generally works at three different levels. Cooperative bank, first level is primary credit societies. Primary credit societies work at village level. They collect deposit from members and general public. They get funds from the state cooperative bank and district cooperative bank for the purpose of lending. Second is district central cooperative bank. This bank operates at district level. They obtain deposit, that is the money, from public at a district level, and they get funds from the state cooperative bank for the purpose of lending. Third type is state cooperative bank. This bank operates at state level. They provide funds to central cooperative bank and primary credit societies. State cooperative bank also perform functions of monitoring over district bank and credit cooperative society. It means they monitor to the district level bank as well as the corporate credit society. Fourth is industrial development banks. Industrial development banks are financial institutions that provides medium and long term funds to the business firms. Example, Industrial Finance Corporation of India, State Finance Corporation, Maharashtra State Financial Corporation. Function of development banks: provision of funds for expansion and modernization. They are providing medium and long term funds. Second, underwriting of shares issued by public limited companies. Third is purchase of debentures and bonds. Fifth point is exchange bank. Exchange bank as well as large commercial bank facilitates foreign exchange transaction. It means they help for doing the foreign exchange transactions. Example, Barclays Bank, Bank of Tokyo, American Express Bank, etc. Function of exchange bank: first, financing foreign trade transaction. Second, issue of letter of credit. Letter of credit is a one kind of becoming a guarantor for doing the transaction of buying and selling of goods from two different countries, and both the buyer and seller doesn't know each other. Discounting of bill of exchange, remittances of dividend, interest, profit, etc. Next is regional rural bank. Regional rural bank, known as RRB, was established in 1975. These banks are sponsored by large public sector bank. Capital of RRB is contributed by three shareholding. First, by central government, they contribute 50%. Second, by state government, they contribute 15%. And the third, by sponsored bank and they contribute 35%. Students, here you can see, even though I had given the image where you can see that 50% is contributed by Government of India, that is the central bank, and next state government has contributed 15% and sponsored bank has contributed 35%. RRB, even though mobilized deposits primarily from rural and semi-urban areas and they provide loans and advances mostly to the farmers, that is the small and the marginal farmers, agricultural laborers and rural artisans. Next is savings bank. Main objective of savings bank is to encourage savings of the people, especially in rural areas. Examples: postal saving bank, commercial banks, cooperative banks. Here students, you can see the image that how people can do the savings which will be useful for their future. And this bank is specially giving the opportunities to the rural people that do the saving and do some investment for their future. Postal saving bank. Post office is also providing the services of saving bank. Every week or every month, they are collecting the money from the public in the form of small savings, and after 1 year they are giving back to the people their savings. So the period may be for the 1 year or it may be for the 5 years. Another image is of a savings bank. So not only the postal saving bank but so many of the commercial bank and cooperative banks, they are providing the facilities to the people to do the savings and invest their money in the form of the saving account where they can do their investment. Next is investment bank. Investment banks provide financial and advisory assistance to their customers. It means they are providing financially help, as well as if any of the customer need any of the advice, that help is also provided to their customers. Clients generally includes business firms and government organizations. Investment bank facilitates merger and acquisition by undertaking research and providing advice on investment decisions. It means they are giving the decisions or advising to the businessmen and government organization where they have to do the investment. Generally, investment bank do not directly deal with general public. Next is specialized bank. Specialized bank are those bank who cater to the requirement and provide overall support for setting up business in specific areas. Example: Export and Import Bank, known as Exim Bank. Second, Small Industries Development Bank of India, known as SIDBI. Third, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, known as NABARD Bank. Students, here you can see the image of the Export and Import Bank of India. Next image is of the SIDBI Bank, Small Industries Development Bank of India. And next is the image of NABARD Bank. Here we can do the detailed study of the three part of the specialized bank. So specialized bank is divided into the three part. First part is Export and Import Bank. Export and Import Bank provides financial assistance to exporter and importer. It also provides financial institution for coordinating working of institution engaged in export and import of goods and services. It tries to promote international trade. Second part is Small Industries Development Bank of India, known as SIDBI. SIDBI was set up on 2nd April 1990 under an Act of Indian Parliament. It acts as a principal financial institution for promotion, financing and development of micro, small and medium enterprises. So SIDBI is specially set up for the development of micro, small and the medium enterprises, as well as they work on the coordination of functions of institutions which are engaged in similar activities. Third is the National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. So it is known as the NABARD Bank. It is an apex institution for financing agriculture and rural areas. NABARD provides both short-term and long-term credit through Regional Rural Bank. It is considered with policy framing and planning and operating related to agricultural credit and providing credit for other activities in rural India. It also provides finance to financial institutions and not to individuals. Thank you, students.